Jesus said, with man, this is impossible.
Yes.
He was talking about entering into the kingdom of heaven. He was talking about salvation. The rich man said, man, I ain't giving up. You know, and the disciples were like, this is a hard thing. Who shall enter into the kingdom then? Who shall be saved? And Jesus said, with man, this is impossible. Salvation, living right, is impossible with man.
Yes.
So you, congratulations, you found out you can't live right on your own.
Yeah.
Willpower ain't gonna cut it.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah,
back
yeah.
into a staff. I'm gonna go over here.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
The Bible says, and he said, put your hand in your bosom. He did, and his hand turned lepers.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Moses gets scared. I got leprosy in my hand. The Bible says, and he said, put your hand back. He did. He brought it out, and it turned.
Amen, amen, amen.
Yeah.
Back into flesh. What are you saying, Ty? All you need for a turnaround is a he said. Tell somebody, all I need is a he said. I don't need change. I don't need help. I don't need it to look like it. If he said it, it has to be. It has to turn.
Yeah,
that's all we need for a bounce back is a he said.
Yeah.
All right, no, girl, let me keep moving. See, they done heard it three times, but they still about to hear me. Y'all with me back here? All right, don't leave me, don't leave me. So, and he said, and it was turned. That's all you need for a shifting in your life. A he said.
He said. Amen, amen.
And we frustrate ourselves because we're doing a lot of things in our own self. Start my business, I'm gonna get this. And we're doing a lot of things and it ain't working. And we mad at God, but did he say
it?
He's not obligated to supply need for what he didn't say. Just because you got a fresh idea and you mad at God because it ain't working out. Did he
say?
Let me move. So judges, man, that's a good point right there. So, man, see, we want God to bless. See, I'm taking a little turn, then I'm coming back. I promise, and then we out of here. Thank y'all for coming. God bless you all. So, I'm taking a little turn. In Genesis chapter 1, verse 1, it says that God created the heaven and the earth, and the earth was without form. Verse 2, chaos. The earth was without form and void and darkness of all this crazy stuff happening to this beautiful thing God created. Right? Just like us. All this turbulence hit us in chaos. And the first thing that you want when crazy stuff hits your life, Lord, bless me. I'm in chaos. I need a blessing right now. Anybody ever pray that while you was in chaos?
Yeah.
It makes sense to us.
Yeah.
We don't see the word, that's verse 2, right? Chaos hit in Genesis 1, verse 2. We don't see the word blessed until verse 22. What was God doing for 20 verses? Don't y'all feel like that sometimes? Like, man, Lord, what are you doing? I waited 11 verses. Where are you at? But when you, when you read the scripture, before he blessed, he put everything back in order.
Amen.
I knew you didn't cry right there. He put it back in order first. See, we want God to bless us, but we're out. We want God to bless something that's out of order. And if you look on any vending machine, on any water fountain, if you see a sign that says out of order, it means it don't work. Man, all right, never mind. I knew that wasn't
good.
You can't expect God to bless something that's out of order. It just doesn't work. Certain relationships we're in, we're wondering why it's not working. Uh-oh. Maybe. It's out of order. So sometimes he allows chaos to hit, not to take you out, but just to restore order. Amen? Alright, I'm out of here. Judges 13, Samson. When I was thinking about bounce back, I thought about Samson. I thought about me, of course, my personal testimony. But I didn't want the night to be about me, which is why we brought other people in, showcase their lives. If you got a bounce back story, everybody has it. Look at Samson. Judges 13 says the people of Israel did evil again.
Talk about it. Come on.
The children of Israel did evil again in the sight of the Lord. I'm like, after the Red Sea, the doorposts, all them plagues. You still, I can't believe that they did evil again until I looked in the mirror. He's performed some miracles in my life too. I had some Red Seas that he parted for me too. He has done, he blessed me too, and I still did evil. Y'all looking real cute tonight, but so did you. Just tell your neighbor, so did I. Did evil again in the sight of the Lord. And the Bible says that the Lord delivered them into the hands of the Philistines. I thought that was real mean. I said, God, just because they messed up again, why you gonna give them to the Philistines? Hey, right? They're your babies, they're your kids. I don't care. You. It's the 9 o'clock. All right, so. Anytime you pray, it's gonna say, this is the 9 o'clock. Yes. It's 9 o'clock. So why would you deliver them into the hands of the Philistines? He said that phrase, deliver them, don't mean I gave them. It simply means I removed my protection. See, some things we're involved with, you know, and they were in slavery and they hit hard times. It wasn't because God is mad at them. You're just not in his presence.
My God.
There are certain things that are just a direct consequence of being out of the presence of God,
that's
of being
right.
disobedient.
That's
he
right.
ain't slap you. That's he it. Ain't kick you. That's he ain't it. Mad at you. You're just not in his protective custody. With him, there's protection. With him, there's provision. With him, there's healing. So I'm not saying all the time that even though you're with him, you don't go through ups and downs. But my point is, we cannot expect him to be responsible for our lives if we're disobedient. It's a consequence.
Yeah.
The prodigal son's father didn't hate him, but he was out of his presence,
right.
Which is why he was broke.
Right. Yeah.
Yes.
The dad didn't take his money. It's a consequence of being out the father's presence. There are certain consequences. It doesn't mean God is mean. He actually takes care of his own.
Right.
Amen?
Yeah.
All right, so now it made me think of, I'm not going to go there. Let me just get out of here.
Yeah.
No, I got to move. So, it's 9 o'clock. It's off the hook. Something wrong with that. So Israel. Israel wouldn't turn to God unless they were like stunned by life, unless life knocked the wind out of them. It took something drastic for them. So that's why their hearts were hardened. Remember he said, in the day that you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Check this out. Ty, how does my heart get hardened? Study this. Your heart gets hardened when, simple, when you hear the word and then don't do it. Little by little, it gets callous and hardened. Little by little, every time you come and hear truth and don't follow through and don't obey it, your heart gets hardened towards truth.
Yeah.
Not just that word, truth.
Yeah.
So it'll be better for you not to hear another word if you don't plan on applying it to your life. Because little by little, your heart gets callous and your heart gets hardened. So this is what happened. So then the word came to my, I see you over here. I'm going. The word came to Samson's mom. She couldn't have kids, but he said it. What'd you say?
They turned it around.
That's right. So she had Samson. Samson was a wild, lustful, impulsive, crazy man with dreads. Don't laugh too hard. Bless your life. He uses his gifts unwisely. He sinned terribly. He often displayed self-centered behavior, yet he was chosen. And it's a mystery to me why God still chooses us and he knows how crazy we are. Y'all hear what I'm saying? Said it in the last, all right, I'm not going to say that.
Come on,
so,
come on, come on.
So
he
chooses us even though he knows we're crazy. But the Bible says, whom he predestined, he foreknew. In other words, God can preset your destination because he knows what you're going to choose. It's not that he controls you, but he knows what you're going to choose, which is why he's predestined you. And even though you're going to fall, he puts little, I call it grace pits. He puts grace pits there because I know he's going to choose that and that ain't right. So let's put some grace there. I know that ain't right. So let's put some mercy there. Oh, he's going to do the grace. Y'all looking at me funny. Remember Jonah? Jonah didn't obey God. They threw him off the boat. And the Bible said God prepared a great fish. He prepared it in the place where he knew Jonah would disobey him.
Yeah.
So the fish caught him when he would have died. We know we made some stupid decisions and we would have died had not something caught us. So Samson is here and his hair is growing. Let me get y'all out of here. His hair is growing and he's going in the strength of God. This is Delilah's lamp. She cuts his hair, cuts his covenant with God, cuts his strength. The Philistines take him and make mockery of him. They joke. They make sport of him. Mm. But the Bible says the devil is so stupid.
Yes,
the Bible says that howbeit his hair began to grow again. See, if you don't kill me, my hair won't grow back. The devil don't understand. Somebody scratch your head and just say, my hair is growing back. I feel something itching up here. My hair is growing back. If you don't take me out, I'm going to come back. If you don't kill me when you got me, I'm going back. That he put his hands on the pillow, I'm getting out of here, and he killed he killed more men in his death than in his life. He killed more men when he died than in his life. God gave me the analogy of floating on water. That when you're in the water, you're fighting, gasping for air, you start sinking.
Right.
But anybody that teach you how to swim and says, act like you're dead.
Right. Amen. Amen.
When you're dead, you float to the top.
That's right.
I miss that.
That's good. That's good.
What the preacher say on Word Network, y'all can't stand this week to change.
Yes.
Ain't no better weekend than this weekend to bounce back.